In this fourth part of video 22, we will measure the clearance between the pistons and cylinders. This is one of the many measurements you will have to take before you can install the pistons with piston rings in the cylinders. Before you measure the pistons and cylinders, make sure they are free of carbon deposits and oil residues. Watch video 21 to learn more about this. Why is piston-cylinder clearance so important? Let's first look at the construction of the piston. On the side of the cylinder head, you have the piston crown. The piston crown, with its compression rings, ensures that the combustion chamber is properly sealed. It is also the part of the piston that helps transfer the heat of combustion to the cylinder wall. An equally important part of the piston is the piston skirt. The piston skirt helps guide the piston into the cylinder with each stroke. The piston skirt is not in direct contact with the cylinder wall. An oil film between the piston skirt and the cylinder wall ensures that the piston moves smoothly in the cylinder. The manufacturer will indicate how much play there may be between the piston skirt and the cylinder wall. This table is from the VW manual for our AB1300 engine. This book dates from 1970. The ideal piston cylinder clearance is indicated by the manufacturer as 0.2 in the table. For a new set of pistons with cylinders, straight from the VW factory, the measured clearance between the piston skirt and the cylinder wall may be between 0.04 and 0.05 of a millimeter. For a used engine, the wear limit is 0.20 of a millimeter. This is our AB1300 engine, with the cylinder head removed. The pistons of cylinder 3 and cylinder 4 are visible in the cylinders. The cylinders are mounted with their flattened sides against each other. The piston crown is on the cylinder head side. The piston skirt is on the crankcase side. When we disassemble the cylinder, the piston skirt becomes visible. The piston skirt is located at the top and bottom of the cylinder. Here we see cylinder 1 with its piston loose on the workbench. The flat part of the cylinder rests on the workbench. In this position, the opening for the piston pin must point upwards. The piston skirt is then on the left and right of the cylinder. Why do we pay so much attention to the position of the piston skirt? It is best to measure the piston cylinder clearance where the clearance really matters. The piston cylinder clearance is the space between the piston skirt and the cylinder wall. The cylinder, inner diameter, that you must measure is the one on the side of the engine crankcase. The measurement of the inner diameter is done parallel to the flat side of the cylinder. That is where the piston skirt slides against the cylinder wall. We will now measure the piston cylinder clearance. We start by measuring the diameter of the piston skirt. The diameter is stated on the piston crown by the manufacturer. These are the pistons of our AB1300 engine. We read 76.95, that is in millimeters. The pistons do not have the same diameter over their entire length. The stated measurement is the diameter of the piston skirt. We measure the diameter of the piston skirt using a calibrated micrometer. The diameter of the piston skirt of cylinder 1 is 76.93 millimeters. That is 0.02 of a millimeter narrower than the factory value. We do the same for cylinder 2. The best place to take the measurement is at the end of the piston skirt. We measure 76.92 millimeters. The piston skirt of cylinder 3 is slightly narrower, namely 76.91 mm. The piston skirt of cylinder 4 has a diameter of 76.95 mm. We summarize the measurements in this table. Cylinder 3 has the greatest deviation from the new value, which is 0.04 mm. To determine the piston cylinder clearance, we now also need to measure the inside diameter of the cylinders. We set the outside diameter micrometer to 77 mm. That corresponds to the inner diameter of our cylinders, according to the factory specifications. To determine the inner diameter, you use an inside diameter micrometer. Unfortunately, this type of micrometer does not provide absolute measurements. It can only indicate a deviation from a zero point. You therefore need an outside micrometer to calibrate the inside micrometer. The inside micrometer comes with various measuring rods. We are looking for a measuring rod that fits between the outside micrometer with a 1 mm preload. The inside micrometer, with the chosen measuring rod, just does not fit between the outside micrometer. We use an extra 3 mm ring. This is too thick. With an extra ring of 2 mm, the inner micrometer fits between the outer micrometer, set to 77 mm. With this setup, we obtain a desired preload of 1 mm. The selected rod must therefore ensure that the dial indicates 1 mm when it is placed between the outer micrometer. 1 mm on the micrometer corresponds to one full rotation of the large dial needle. You can also see from the small needle that the inner micrometer spindle has been pushed in 1 mm. You can now set the zero point. Move the inner micrometer between the outer micrometer until the maximum deflection of the large dial needle is reached. The maximum deviation is equal to the zero point. Turn the outer disc of the dial to place the large needle on the zero on the measuring scale. We check the set zero point with the outside micrometer fixed in the vise. We tilt the inside micrometer. The large needle fluctuates around the set zero point. The inside micrometer is now ready to be used to measure our cylinders. Slide the inside micrometer 15 mm into the cylinder. We want to measure the inside diameter where the piston skirt passes back and forth, as explained earlier in this video. That is parallel to the flat side of the cylinder. Tilt the inside micrometer back and forth until the big needle reaches its maximum. Each line to the left of the zero point corresponds to 0.01 mm greater than 77 mm. We can see that the inner diameter is 0.03 mm larger than 77 mm. That is 77.03 mm. Don't forget to keep an eye on the small needle. It should still indicate 1 mm of preload. We take several measurements, each time going 15 mm deeper into the cylinder. Each time, we measure 77.03 mm. That is a wear of 0.03 mm, compared to the cylinder's new condition. We summarize the measurements for all cylinders. The highest cylinder piston clearance is that of cylinder 3, and amounts to 0.12 mm. That is higher than the new part's value, but still well below the wear limit. So, it's not too bad for this used engine. If you would like more information about using the inside diameter micrometer, watch part 5 of this video. We will then show you how to measure the out of round of the cylinders. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon!